Hey guys, so I wanted to do a little before video. I'm going to get my hair cut. Scruffy, fluffy, sides are getting really long. So that's what I'm doing today. We'll see how it goes. So, this is Bethany. You may have just seen the footage of her cutting my hair. Fabulous, fabulous stylist. Comes here at Scissors and Scotch in Brentwood. So we're just going to do a quick interview and ask a few questions about the experience. So, hopefully you enjoy. So, did you ever have deaf customers before me, before I came in?
So, actually, you were my first deaf client, but I've had two deaf clients now at this point, and the experience I had with you helped me with him as well. Okay. So it was actually very helpful. I've had other accommodations and special needs in my chair, but definitely you were my first deaf client.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Before I came in, how much did you know about sign language?
Zero.
Zero.
Literally zero.
Nothing. Never practiced the alphabet.
No. Well, maybe in elementary school, a little bit. I might have learned a few alphabet letters, but that was it.
Yeah.
So I have no experience.
Okay.
Yep.
And how much would you say that you knew about the deaf community as a whole?
Also, not very much. Yeah. I've had, I guess, situations here and there where I've been in communication groups where somebody was, and either someone with them knew sign language, or they knew how to read lips. So I was never confronted with a very hard situation for me to communicate to them. So that's always been helpful. But yeah, not a whole lot.
Kind of the reason for this channel is
yeah,
not a whole
no,
lot.
Yeah, no, I think it's really
in both
helpful.
Directions.
Yeah.
So there's not a lot of knowledge in the hearing community about the deaf community. Mm-hmm. And then in the deaf community, there's not a whole lot of understanding of the hearing community either. So
yeah.
Since I kind of come from one and then transition into the other, I feel like it's a good opportunity for me to kind of help educate on both sides.
Absolutely.
So hopefully it's helpful. When you first got that first call that I was coming in, I'm assuming they told you because
yes.
You spoke to the manager, and then I'm assuming the manager gave you the heads up that I was deaf and I was
yes.
coming in. So how nervous or concerned were you?
So, honestly, not very nervous. I had kind of already thought through how I would communicate, and that was the best way I figured I could do that was to voice communicate in a note in my phone so that you could read what I had to say, and from there I figured maybe you could type or I could try to communicate somehow from there, but I was like, this seems like a perfect start.
Yeah.
So,
yeah,
so that
was kind of the first thing that came to your mind.
Yeah, so I was just creatively problem solving in that moment because I was like, I don't know enough about how to do communication in other forms, but this seems like it'll work.
Okay.
So, yeah.
Perfect.
And we were given a little extra time with your haircut for that communication.
Right.
So that was helpful too, getting the extra time with you so that I could take my time to communicate through.
Right.
Yeah.
So does it have a big impact on your schedule if I make an appointment to come in and you know that I'm coming? Does it change your time slots drastically in any way?
Not drastically. I'd say we added about 15 extra minutes for just a little extra time to communicate that. So an extra 15 minutes is usually pretty helpful.
Okay.
Yeah.
So with me coming in, what was your outside of the communication and using it, what was your primary concern about that first initial appointment, and even the subsequent appointments after that?
Primary concern for me is I'm a talker. I love to get to know my clients, and I knew that it would be slightly more difficult because I can't stop cutting hair to talk into my phone. So learning to be able to read your lips a little bit too, or having you comfortable enough to speak to me has helped tremendously.
To clarify, I did not speak the first 6 times I came in here. This
no.
is my first time here speaking.
Yeah.
I normally don't talk in public, so.
Yeah, I obviously understand why that would be uncomfortable too. So in the first few appointments, I was definitely starting to learn how to read your lips, which was helpful. And but otherwise, I just always kind of concerned that I wouldn't be able to get to know you on a personal level as easily as I could my other clients. So it's helpful to be able to do that because then you can get to have a conversation and be more comfortable with the person in your chair. So that was, I think, probably my biggest concern in it all.
Sure. Okay. So how different was that initial experience from what you were expecting? So I know, I'm sure before it came in, you had a mindset of what it was going to be like, again, talking into the notes
yeah.
and communicating back and forth like that. How different was that first experience? Was it easier than you thought it would be? Was it harder than you thought it would be?
It was actually easier than I thought it would be.
Okay.
It went smoother than I expected it to be because I feel like you had a lot easier time communicating back to me than I thought
yeah.
would be the case. So that was actually really a nice surprise, I guess. Yeah.
Well, using the phone the first couple of visits, that was
yeah.
a really nice idea, a really nice touch, because it made it easy for me to be able to type back or to read very quickly and not misunderstand what you were saying by
yeah.
just the reading and stuff. And it kept me comfortable because I didn't feel forced to have to speak.
Yes.
That created a comfort level for me that was very crucial and very good So, which goes back to what I always tell people, a little bit of effort goes a long way.
Yeah.
Are you more confident now to work with other deaf customers than you were previously based on like our experiences?
For sure. And actually what that also helped is my other client who's deaf goes to multiple people in here, and I was able to coach them as well on how I communicate with him. And so it just made it the whole experience a lot easier for the whole shop. So
that's sharing that knowledge. That's good. That's what we're trying to do here.
Yes,
sharing
that
knowledge. I love that. It's also so wonderful that you have another experience to go off of than just mine. On that first experience, how difficult would you say the communication was? And then on a scale of 1 to 10, now that you've become more accustomed, how has that shifted?
I would say on a scale from 1 to 10 difficulty-wise, because I had a manager who had prepared me mentally for it, it really didn't seem hard. It was just a little bit more time-consuming. So you just have to take that extra time. Now, I feel like we've been doing communications long enough, and I know what kind of haircuts you like, but it's a lot faster. So I feel like maybe it started at maybe a 4. And probably now it's at a 2.
Right.
Yeah, so
very similar to having someone in the chair that was hearing. It's just that little bit of extra consciousness.
Yeah, it's just a little extra time for the communication. It's not that it's harder, it's just a little extra time needed. Yeah.
Would you like to shout out your socials? Do you want people to follow anything? Okay.
I'm really bad at social media, guys. The Scissors and Scotch one is Bethany-H-Scissors-and-Scotch, or Scissors Scotch Nash.
Like down here.
Perfect.
I would just like to say thank you for everything that you do with trying your best to communicate with me in as clear and as most comfortable of a fashion as you possibly can. I'm glad that it's already started to bleed over into other experiences for you.
Yeah. And also, thank you for being patient and willing to work with me. So it goes both ways.
It's important to show how easy it can be.
Yeah, absolutely.
It just takes a little bit of adjustment. Well, again, thank you, and I really appreciate it.
Yep.